And then, you know, I finally gathered up the courage and knocked that brush clean out. You have no clue what
Look,
that brush looked like right
you
now.
look. Uh-oh. I hear Peggy P in the house. Look, she's on the. Give me her.
Hey!
Woo!
Love you.
She's been waiting to do that all day. Love me some bladder flare. All right, let me
Woo!
look. Hell yeah. I was out running the dogs. She was
I'll
running
be
the dogs
back.
in the field. She heard you. She came running. All right. James, we're
That's
trying to get you in here. We want to hear from you. Let's see. Let me give him one more request. We'll see what happens. We can't get him in here, but we'll maybe switch over. All right. Somebody said Lenny Kravitz Jr. I could see some Lenny Kravitz going on with that bandana, that headband.
I was Lenny Kravitz accidental child, you know. He didn't know about me, but I knew about him.
Oh, you guys are, these comments are killing me right now. I love it. I'm so glad we jumped on
Just
Golden Boy
that
because,
out.
you know, I mean, you get a whole different group of followers in here. I love it.
Wow. Whoa, that's crazy. Some of these fans remember me way back.
There you go. See?
James Shula's gym. Amateurs. Okay, yeah. Yeah, we was crushing them back in the day, right?
All
Yeah.
right.
Yeah, man.
We got Philly in the house. See, I'm not gonna talk too much smack on Philly because I am PA, but you know Pittsburgh and Philly, we
Oh
kinda,
man,
you
I
know.
love them both. It was
That's great.
epic that like Philly won that Super Bowl. At least we got one then.
You got one, and I'll give you that. We've got enough, so I'll give you that
Now
one.
look, the Pittsburgh Steelers been killing it for centuries.
That's right. That's
That's
true.
been my
That's
backup.
true.
My backup has been always the Pittsburgh. Like
Really?
once the Eagles went down, I was like, all right, come on, Pittsburgh.
That's right. No, we've got a good franchise for sure. There's a lot of Steelers fans all over the world. When's
Yeah, and
Canelo
it's
gonna
all.
get in the chat here? Hey, I think we're starting a trend here on this live. So who knows? Who might jump on next?
Look, everybody that's on the live right now, if you guys are die hard Cowboy fans, you gotta leave right now. Just get off my
Out of here.
channel right now.
Ellie, where's Ellie? I see a shout out to Ellie. My boy Ellie Setback. We
Ellie
love you,
Setback
Ellie.
reporting.
That's right. AB Boxing, my boy. We see, we're getting everybody back together. I love this. I miss boxing so much. Like I can't tell you. It's crazy because it's like a big family, you know. You see each other so much and you work together so much and when stuff like this happens and you don't get to reconnect, sucks. Let's
So,
see. What's in here?
check this out. What made you fall in love with boxing?
You know, it's funny, and I actually wanted to talk to James about this too, but way back in the day, I mean, my cousins were always really into boxing. So growing up, I was surrounded by boys and obviously with a name like Billy, a little bit of a tomboy. So I was always into sports. But you know, I really got into boxing it's probably 10 years ago, and I worked alongside Roy Jones Jr. There was actually a pretty good boxing scene here in Pittsburgh. So there was a casino called Rivers Casino, still here, but it's kind of, you know, it's not as big as it used to be. But, you know, I used to work a lot of events there, and I really got into boxing probably, say, about 10 years ago, which I'm really dating myself right now, but you know, and just the more that I got involved with the sport, even as a job, I think you have a newfound respect for the athletes, you know, what goes into it. And it really is. I mean, it's not just, you know, about your boxing ability. It's a business, and there's a lot that goes into it, and the dedication that you guys put in, it's amazing. So I love being there ringside for all these big fights and to see, you know, and a lot of these boxers come up. It's cool to watch. So that's probably my favorite. Oh, Randy, I see you. She was actually with me way back in the day, for when we worked for Roy and all those guys back in Pittsburgh. I love seeing all these people come out of the woodwork when you go on live. It's great. I love it.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, man. That's great. I don't even know how I fell into boxing.
Yeah? On the mean streets of Philly.
Man, don't even get me started about the mean streets of Philly.
No, but you know what? I mean,
I was dipping all kinds of stuff, man. My dip game was incredible. You know, you got to be fast to dip bullets.
That's right.
Bullets and speed in cars because people don't stop.
Yeah. I'm trying to read the comments. They're going so quick here. All right. Let's see. And we got to get James in here. I'm trying to figure out. I don't know. Maybe we can't have three on at one time. So maybe that's the issue.
Crunch time.
So, James, yeah, throw us a request if you can. Rima said, I miss our Big Bear training camps, Blair. You trained at Big Bear?
Yeah. I actually trained in Big Bear for the Shane Mosley fight. For Shane Mosley and Manny Pacquiao. Yeah. I was only an amateur at that time. But I was incredibly fast, like I am always now. And I have a special talent that not very many people have. And when it came to like Manny Pacquiao, you got a special fighter, so then you need a special talented person in order to like combat that, to be prepared for such a thing. Sure. I just feel bad for the people that got prepared for me.
That's right.
Because and like Pacquiao, they only come around every once in maybe a good generation.
Right.
So, and like sometimes those fighters that have those type of abilities, they might not even make it, you know, because of what's happening outside of the ring or like finances or, you know, it's a lot of things that happen.
That go into it.
Yeah, there's a lot of factors.
Have the sheer talent, but
Or politics and things like that. So a lot of them might not even, be revealed
to the world. Get their opportunity.
Like, yeah, sure. Yeah. Like Roy Jones was just one of like so many fighters in each generation, and Roy Jones finally made it, and he made it early enough for everybody to see his talent.
Right.
You know, but there's people like that, you know, like myself.
Absolutely. All right. Let's see. All right. They're giving you props, Blair. Said, I knew you'd succeed with that work ethic. Let's see here. That is my man, James. We gotta get him in here. Let me see. Let me try one more request. Blair the Flair versus Ryan Garcia, King Rye. We love King Rye.
That's my partner right there.
That's right. It's your teammate.
We're killing the game.
Isn't that the truth?
You guys want to hear some funny stories? Y'all want story time?
Give us the tea. Look, I got my tea ready. Let's go, Blair.
Tea and a good Bang energy drink. Shout out to everybody from Bang. You know?
There you go.
They busting those checks.
Hey, whatever works. Let's see.
Man, I got a lot of stories, too. All right, how about this? You know, there's been two times where I nearly crashed the airplane. Yeah. Two times that nearly happened. I'm dabbling with my father. You know, we go out to, you know, just all kinds of stuff. When you have an airplane, life is different.
Yeah, I'm sure.
It feels normal, but it's different.
Yeah.
Like, for instance, we will come to Vegas for lunch. You know, we live in Beverly Hills. So we'll come to Vegas for lunch and then come back like as if it was nothing.
Lifestyles of the rich and famous.
yeah, right. So now, one time, we were flying, and we were going to, I think it's called Catalina Island.
Yeah, Catalina is beautiful.
It's a little island just off the coast of Los Angeles or something. So somewhere in that area in California, I think that's what it's called. Anyways. We're flying over there, and we had a good time. We came there, ate breakfast or something. And on the way out, my father was like, oh, you know what would be cool? We should go in between the mountains. I'm like, all right, cool. Let's go in between those mountains. That sounds good. We're going to have a really good view. Yeah, it was a really good view. So we get hit by like turbulence on both sides of the airplane, one this way and one that way.
Because oh, see, I can't do turbulence.
So the turbulence done pushed us over to a point where like we're like this. And mind you, we don't have a special airplane that got like that can flip around and all that. So if it goes like that, it's over. We're going.
Right.
We're hitting that beach. And we're just falling down towards the beach, towards the shoreline, and just barely we passed the mountains, and all that turbulence done passed us up, and we're able to like even out the plane and pull up just before we hit that beach.
No, thank you. That would have been the last flight I ever took. I'll tell you that much.
Yeah, I was always just, I was just stupid enough to do it enough times, you know.
But you know what? You've got that like fighter mentality. You're not scared of anything. So, I mean, comes with the territory, I guess. All right, let me see here.
Second time.
Wait, you got to say, let's hear about the second time.
Second time I nearly died on an airplane.
Remind me to never fly with you, Blair.
Yeah. Oh, trust me. We're going to be totally fine. Always fly with me because I'm like a good luck charm.
Well, there you go. This is true. I guess you made it through.
So the second time we had a different airplane. And this one we had two propellers. It's a big airplane.
Yeah.
Big one with two propellers. And we're flying and I forget where we're going. It's somewhere far because we were on autopilot for the longest. And my father's asleep and I'm just bopping to Aerosmith. You know,
like, Aerosmith, there you go. Yeah. That was actually the last concert I went to before all this craziness. I saw Aerosmith in Vegas. Yes. If you guys ever legit concert, I actually had pretty amazing seats, but it was, I mean, at their age.
Oh, you know what? I seen that.
Unreal. Yeah. Definitely a bucket list moment for me, for sure. I love me.
That's amazing. So yeah. I'm listening to Aerosmith, and I'm just so emotional. Crazy, baby.
Look, you guys didn't know you were going to have a little serenade from right? Flair to Flair.
And then I look over, and one of the propellers stopped moving. I'm like, oh, Jesus Christ. Okay.
That's never a good sign.
I'm like, hey, Dad. He's like, sleep. He's like, huh, what? What's going on? I'm like, man, you know, it's gonna be a bad day. He's like, what you talking about now? What is it? You gotta go to the bathroom? I'm like, no, I ain't gotta go to the bathroom. It was like, look, man, this propeller over here ain't working no more. he leans forward to look at at the propeller. He's like, oh shit, oh man, and he's touching every dial in the airplane just to realize that there's no way that propeller's turning on. I know that. I'm just like, you know what? I've never been through this in a flight simulator, but this is going to be a wicked ride.
It's real time now. But the moral of the story is you made it, right? You made it. You're here.
Yeah. We just barely made it because there was an airstrip as we were, making a descent, and we couldn't. One propeller wasn't enough to get us to keep us in the air, we were falling. But luckily, we found an airstrip just in time.
Well, that's good. I mean, hey, if I ever need a pilot, I guess
don't
I wouldn't mind you.
My father.
I mean, if you survive two plane crashes, I'll take it. Let's see. All right, let's get back to the fans. Everybody's commenting here. I know we're going to get crunch time in here. I may have to let you go, Blair, because I think for some reason it's not letting us get him on with all of us together. Jay Stoops, my Instagram is at Billy Joe Powers. Blair, let him have it. At Blair the Flair.
Okay. Hey, Hey, hold up. For people
Yeah, go
that
ahead. Answer some questions if you see anything
Yeah,
in there.
let's answer a couple questions right
Yeah.
quick.
And then we're
What
gonna
was the
get
first
crunched in
fight
one here.
you ever fought? Fight like, okay, the first fight I ever fought, how was that like? That was pretty tough. I fought with only 2 weeks of training. So
Two
I had
weeks.
like zero wins, zero conditioning, you know?